Hi everybody, thanks so much for coming back to 1minutedigital.com. Today I'm going to show you how to do some quick, very simple photograph effects in Adobe Photoshop. Just how to fade images into nothingness or into blackness, also to ghost them one on top of another, cut hole out of one to show one underneath with this nice kind of faded out effect. It's very, very simple. We're not meticulously cutting anything out. We're just going to use the gradient tool and the feather tool to make our images sort of blend together. So the first one I'm going to do is this forest image here, and I got these images from morguefile.com. It's a great place for free images. If you go there, there's a lot of really high quality images to choose from. So that is where I got the images I'm working with today. So let's go ahead and open that new one. And I believe that was this one. And there's our forest image, and that's how it comes from morguefile, or from wherever you download it from the internet. Most of them are going to be 72 DPI. So if you're going to be printing, the first thing you need to do is go to image mode, change it to CMYK, OK, and image size, and change the DPI with none of these boxes checked to 300. Now again, these steps are only for printing if you're going to wind up printing your project. If it's just for the internet, you don't need to bother with this right now. Okay, let's double click on the background layer to unlock it. And now go over to, actually let's make another layer first. At the bottom you have a little paper icon. Click on that, that makes another layer on top of your image. Go over to your toolbar and find the gradient tool. Up here at the top toolbar, make sure that foreground to transparent is checked, because that will start at a color and fade out into nothingness instead of fade out into another color, and that's what you want. So with this top layer selected, I'll zoom out a little bit. Hold down shift, click outside the image on the bottom, and drag upwards. And you can see what it's doing is creating, if you look at the layer preview, it's creating a sort of black faded out layer. It's not cutting or destroying this image in any way, it's just covering it up a little bit. But the effect is that it looks like these trees are fading out into black. Now you can double click on this layer and change the color by clicking on color overlay and sample any color that might be inside the image to begin with. You can make it white, black, you can select any of the green of the tree, kind of a yellowish green, whatever you want to do for your project, but it makes the effect is the same. It makes it look like it's fading out into a color or into blackness. Say okay, and now you can type on top of it without fearing that your type is going to compete with the image underneath, because that's what we do not want. There, now your type pops out instead of trying to compete with the image that's underneath. So that looks pretty good. That's our first one. Now let's work on our little lady sitting inside this flower. Again, I got these from morguefile, so I'm going to go ahead and open those images. Here is the young lady. And let's open the flower image. And I'm going to go ahead and do those printing steps again. Again, if you're not going to print, don't worry about this, but let's change our image to 300 DPI, none of these being checked. Change this resolution to 300. Okay. And our mode to CMYK, that is for printing. And we're going to do the same to her. Image mode CMYK. And image size 300 DPI. Okay. So now let's go over to our flower image. Select all. You can do that by going select all, or you can do Command A. And copy it. And now let's paste it on top of our young lady there. And you can see it's huge. It's much, much bigger than the picture of her, so we need to make that smaller. Hover over the left-hand corner, hold down shift, and drag it. Move it back. Just keep dragging it. You're holding down shift to keep it in proportion. If you don't hold down shift, it'll go all wacky on you. Hit enter, and now we have, here's our two images, one of her and one of the flower. Double-click on the image, the bottom image, because it's going to unlock it. Now it says layer 0 and layer 1, that's what you want. Now let's go over to our toolbar. Select the elliptical marquee tool. Up here on the top toolbar you'll see there's a feather and a box. It defaults to 0. Change that to 7580 pixels. That will depend on how big your images are, but you'll see what I mean. This is going to feather the edge of your selection, so it's not just a hard cutout, it's a nice faded back cutout. So with our top layer selected, let's draw a circle where we think we want her to be sitting. I think right here is good, sort of in the middle. Again, make sure you're on the right layer, you're going to cut the wrong one out. After you've drawn that, just hit delete, and there she is peeking through. And if you turn her off, you can see what you've done is you've made a hole in that picture. So it would be a good idea to make a copy of that one first before you cut it out, just in case you want to do it again, you'll have a copy of it. But we have made a hole in that. There she is underneath. And because you've unlocked that bottom layer, when you select it, you can move her around now and put her kind of wherever you want. I think that looks pretty good. There she is showing through that flower. A design tip, because the flower is facing to the left and she is facing to the right, I like to have them both facing the same way just to look a little bit better in our image. So with the bottom layer selected, I'm going to go to Edit, Transform, Flip Horizontal. That makes her facing the same way as the flower is facing, like she's just sitting in there. The other thing I would point out is if you zoom in very close, you can see here, if you turn off that flower, that image stops there. We can't do anything more with that. So you can either Photoshop more feet in so that it fades out and you can see her feet, or you can just add another layer on top of the lady. Again, use your gradient tool, hold down shift, click and drag, and kind of that will fade it out and make sure that we don't show that cutoff layer so we can see her where her feet end and the picture ends. So now it's all clean and she looks like she's just sort of sitting in there. And that's a nice postcard to make, or a birthday card for someone for your project. Just sort of one thing fading into another. And that's how you do it in Photoshop using the gradient tool. Okay, thanks so much for watching. I really hope this helped you. And don't forget to like or subscribe and go ahead and tweet me at 1MinDigital on Twitter. Thanks so much. Until next time. Bye-bye.